A warm welcome to this session on SharePoint list creation using PowerShell. A SharePoint list is the fundamental building block which stores all the data needed. Behind the scenes, SharePoint list contents are stored in the SQL database. There are many ways to create SharePoint list. We can use the server-side object model or the client-side object model. For this demo, we are going to have a look at PowerShell way of coding to get the SharePoint list created. PowerShell is very easy. We can finish off lots of tasks just with few lines of code, and creation of list is also very easy. We'll just go ahead with the fundamentals before moving on to the code. Before creating a list, we need to decide the properties of the list. For example, the name or the title, what is the list type, what is the description for the list. Then you would have to decide where would you want to place the list. It might be under a site collection, or you might want the list to be created in multiple site collections. In that case, PowerShell is very powerful. Finally, we need to write down the code. The pseudocode is, first you get a reference to the site object with the URL. Then you get the list object. After that, you create all the variables needed to store the list properties, like the title, the description, and the template types. After that, you merely add the new list using the add method in PowerShell. And that's it. Your PowerShell list has been created. Log into your SharePoint server and right-click the PowerShell icon at the desktop below and run ISC as administrator. Ensure that you always run the PowerShell as an administrator. Once the window is open, let's start typing our code. First, we need to get a reference to the site. For that, $spweb is equal to, use the command get-spweb, we'll pass the site parameter and get the reference to a local site collection named. You may replace this URL with the URL of your SharePoint site. Next step is to get the list for all the list. We'll store that in $splist is equal to $spweb dot. If you put a dot, if you observe, PowerShell is so easy. It makes our life so much easier. You get all the properties. Put an L and you'll get all the list. You press tab or enter and you're done. Next, we'll see how to add a list. We'll press splist dot if the IntelliSense does not work, just run the previous commands. You can select them and press F8. Now try to give a dot. It comes, all the properties and methods come. If you keep going down, these are all the various properties. For example, count gives the count of list in the particular web. Let's try to add the list. If you go over add, see that look at the, there are lots of parameters. For example, GUID add, string title, string description. There are multiple overloads for this list. If you observe, the first method passed the parameters of string title, string description, and Microsoft.SharePoint.SPListTemplateType. So let's go ahead and prepare all those properties. So first is the list title. Dollar list title. So these are the properties which the add method wanted: the list title, list description, and the list template. List title is nothing but a variable. Dollar list title is equal to, in our example, let's create a simple fruits list. The list description. This list stores all fruits. Next, the list template, if you see, there is a method called Microsoft.SharePoint.SPTemplateType, which is of enum, and this is what we are going to find out. Now, we do not know what are all the list types available. How can we see? There is one easy way. There is something called system.enum. Dot get values of if I merely execute this. I'm sorry, this is spelling error. List template type. Let's try again. So these are all the list templates. For the fruits, we shall try which template? We shall try the generic list template. So I'm merely typing the SP list template type. And press two colons. It lists all the properties. We shall select generic list from the drop down. Which refers to the normal customer. Next, we merely call the add method $SPList.add of, we are passing the list title, next the list description, next template type. If you observe, the $SPList.add, this method returns a GUID. We shall return the value of the GUID after the creation. $GUID equal to, and display a list with GUID, $GUID created successfully. I'm merely saving this for now in the demo folder and renaming this as create fruits. And now I press run or F5. I forgot to comment this $SP list, which is continuously displaying all the lists in the site. I'll just comment this. If you want to stop the execution, you can either press the red symbol here or press Ctrl C. Let's run the script again. Very good, a list with GUID created successfully. Let's go to the site contents of the site and see. We will refresh site contents. Very good. A fruits list is created. So, as a quick summary, we have decided to create a simple list called fruits of the generic list type. First, we get a reference to the website of your URL, get-spweb-site. Your URL you can give, the SharePoint site URL. Next, we get a reference to the list, all the lists present inside the SharePoint site, and store them inside the SPLists variable. After that, we get the decide the title, description, and the template type. Title and description are written as per your wish. You can decide the title and description. And it is recommended that you do not put unnecessary spaces inside the title. Next is to decide the list template type. We can get all the list template types using the statement system.enum colon colon get values of microsoft.sharepoint.sp-list-template-type. There are many, many list template types available. The most commonly used list template types are generic list, document library, survey, anyway, announcements, contacts, calendar, task list. And so they start with mostly the numbers 100, 101, 102, etc. So after you decide the list template type, you merely add the list GUID SPList.add of the title, description, and the template type. And we observe that this returned of the type GUID, and we just merely display the GUID once the list is created. So this is a summary again. We decide the properties of the list, decide where the list resides, the URL of the SharePoint site. Finally, we get the PowerShell code. We get the site object, get list object, create the list properties, add the list using the add method, passing the parameters, title, description, and template type. Thank you.